Damn! Okay. As you already know, just by judging by the first clip of this video, I just saw the Avengers last night, and I'm excited to tell you what I think about it. You know what I'm going to say about it. It's fucking awesome! Okay, I need to calm down. I need to calm down. But still, no. This movie, it's worth it. You gotta see this movie. You haven't seen it. After you get done watching this review, watch it right now, because this movie is worth it. What happens if you put Iron Man, Captain America, Thor, The Incredible Hulk, Black Widow, Hawkeye, and Nick Fury, who has a few scenes in this movie? You have a genuine masterpiece of all time. I would say this is the best movie so far this year. I have seen a few movies that were, well, they were good. They were good, but not good like this. Not awesome like this. Because, yeah, let me get down to the point. The whole basic part of the movie is the Avengers, you know, they come together because of Nick Fury. Loki is basically planning to control mankind, and now he basically wants to have, remember in Captain America, the cube that was, Red Skull had in Captain America? Well, basically he's using that to control the humans and cause, I don't know, some type of gateway to, from another world for, I don't know, it was something like that, yeah. But, let's not forget, this movie has the best, I gotta tell you, the dialogue in this movie is just funny. And I mean, everybody was laughing at every single moment. No, every single dialogue in this movie, it was hilarious, it was funny, it was, yeah. I'm gonna say this again, you gotta go see this movie. You really gotta go see this movie right now. It's worth it. It's really worth it. It's really worth your time. It's really worth your money. All that. See this in full price. Full price only. Or Better Than Sex or something like that. What else? Alright, basically, we go down to some stuff I actually liked about the movie. I liked Captain America because he was mostly kind of like being the second leader of the group. But, you know, Nick Fury, he's obviously the leader of the group, but when it came down to the final act, that's when they all start working as a team. Because earlier, when it came down to Captain America, Iron Man, well, basically just Iron Man and Thor fighting each other, that was awesome. It was by far the best battle I've ever seen since Freddy vs. Jason, Alien vs. Predator. I think that might be just it. But that was clearly the best crossover battle that I've ever seen so far. And when it came down to Thor trying to fight Captain America, it kind of just happens just like that. Just when Thor, like, lays down his hammer on Captain America's, you know, shield, that's when, you know, they just stop and they're like, are we done? Well, yeah. But then later in the film, when it came down to them, for Nick Fury, Bruce Banner, Tony Stark, Captain America, and Thor, did I mention Nick Fury? In one room having a big, huge argument, that was actually, well, very interesting, because they were having a really good argument, and they were all throwing, basically showing their ego and putting their ego on the line. Yeah. Oh, and let me get down to Loki. Loki is by far the best villain I've seen in a film. Now, yeah. Loki is basically, there was a really funny scene where I actually burst out at laughing, where Loki was battling the Incredible Hulk, He's like, I'll not be bullied by you. And then later the Hulk just starts slamming him down on the ground and just keeps slamming him and just nonstop. And everybody was just bursting out of laughing. Just bursting out of laughing. So basically, Loki released these monsters from another world by using the cube and him having this staff that has, like, that he can easily control humans with, you know. And he tries it with Tony Stark, but it doesn't seem to work. Seeing how he has that, you know, thing that's in his chest. But still, what else have I not mentioned? Oh, the final battle where they're all working together and when they're all standing. You know where you see them all standing together in that little small circle in the middle of New York? That is by far the best action sequence. And it is just nonstop, epic action. And I mean epic action from here to there to everywhere. You know, it's definitely what you want to see from a summer blockbuster. You really got to see this movie. Oh, and let me get down to another thing. I know you all probably might have seen my live-action Sailor Moon rant. And how I mentioned Josh Whedon was going to be directing that movie. Well, was supposed to be directing that movie, but it was actually rumored. I was not attacking him personally. No, I wasn't. I was attacking the whole entire idea of them making a live-action Sailor Moon movie. That's it. You know, using American female actors to play Sailor Moon without getting, like, Asian actors. Now, yeah, I want to point that out. I was not attacking him at all. I know he has a big, huge fan base that he's basically a big, huge fanboy of this stuff. And if it wasn't for him, I gotta give him credit for this movie because he actually made this movie work. He actually made the characters likable. He actually made them enjoyable. He actually made all the characters in this movie. And I mean, even Loki, he even was a likable villain. He was a very likable villain and I enjoyed him. I enjoyed every single thing about him. He was intimidating. He was enjoyable. He was everything that a villain needed to be. But I will give him credit. I will give him complete, utter. I will give him basically, I gotta give him props. I gotta give Josh Whedon props for making this movie. Because this movie was perfect. It was doing what it needed to be doing. It was definitely the best movie I've seen. Well, there is The Dark Knight Rises. There is Spider-Man. The Amazing Spider-Man. But I'm giving this movie, out of 5 stars, I'm giving it literally 5 stars. Yes. I'm giving this movie 5 stars because I enjoyed it. I enjoyed every single moment of it. And I think I said everything I needed to say. Yeah, if you get a chance, no matter of fact, after you get done watching this review, see this movie right now. This movie is worth it, worth your money. Oh, and I have heard it's good in 3D. So yeah, see it in 3D. And judging by some of the scenes that happen in the movie, it's really worth seeing in 3D. I'm not a big fan of 3D or anything like that, but see it in 3D. So, that's my review. Hope you enjoyed it. Vertical Spy, signing out.